Hello and welcome to this video on blockchain technology. In this video, we'll explore what blockchain is, how it works, and why it's so revolutionary. So without any further delay, let's get started with the topic. First, a quick disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor. Alright, now let's get right into this video. And before we start, I do want to say that if you want links or if you want to check out the content we'll talk about in this video, then you should know that all the links will be down in the description. So definitely check that out. So the first thing we need to talk about when talking about blockchain technology is simply what it is. Later in the video, we will also go a little bit more into depth. I think that's important and I think that's very valuable to know for all of you. But first, a little bit about what is blockchain technology. So blockchain, and this is sometimes referred to as distributed ledger technology or DLT, makes the history of any digital assets unalterable and transparent through a decentralized network and cryptographic hashing that's used in the entire consensus and how it actually works. But more about that a bit later. So a simple analogy to make it a bit more understandable perhaps is that blockchain technology can be compared to how a Google Docs document works. When you create a Google Doc and share it with a group of people, the document is simply distributed instead of copied or transferred. And this creates a decentralized distribution chain that gives everyone access to the base document at the same time. And no one is locked out awaiting changes from another party while all modifications on the document are being recorded in real time, making changes completely transparent. A significant gap though where this analogy ends is that unlike Google Docs, original content and data on the blockchain cannot be modified once written, adding to its level of security. So to go on a little bit about the analogy, basically see it like this, every new sentence that gets written will stay there and only new sentences can be added and no old ones can be removed without removing the first one. And then altogether, what you will have in a blockchain technology, you have different blockchains obviously in the world. You have Bitcoin, which is mainly only used for transactions, but you also have the Ethereum blockchain where you can actually store and do way more with the blockchain. So you can, for example, have your own address, which leads to your own wallet, and there's mining. You have different tokens on one specific blockchain. You have transactions, as I said, smart contracts, and way more. So basically, a blockchain can be seen as a network of different products, different apps, and different people. Now let's talk a bit about the importance of blockchains. So blockchain is an up-and-coming and revolutionary technology because it helps reduce security risks, stamp out fraud, and brings transparency in a stable way. And of course, this whole blockchain technology is popularized by its association with cryptocurrencies and NFTs. But blockchain technology has since evolved to become a management solution, for example, for all types of global industries. So today you can find blockchain technology providing transparency for the food supply chain, for example, securing healthcare data, innovating gaming, and overall changing how we handle data and ownership in a larger scale. So it's definitely, I think, important to know about blockchain and to know about all the different possibilities there are with it. So now let's dive a bit more into the technological side of a blockchain. And for this blockchain, we will talk about the Bitcoin blockchain, which is proof of work. And for proof of work blockchains, basically it consists of three important concepts: blocks, nodes, and miners. So every chain, every blockchain consists of multiple blocks, and each block has three basic elements: the data and the block, the nonce, which is basically a whole number that's randomly generated when a block is created, and the hash, which is a number permanently attached to the nonce. And for Bitcoin hashes, these values must start with a huge number of zeros. And what happens is when the first block of a chain is created, a nonce generates the cryptographic hash, and the data in the block is considered signed and forever tied to the nonce and hash unless it's mined. So what a miner then does is they create the new blocks on a chain through a process called mining. So they use special software to solve the incredibly complex math problem of finding a nonce that generates an accepted hash to the previous block in the blockchain. So when that actually happens, when they find that, they are said to have found the golden nonce and their block is added to the chain and they gain a reward. And that way the blockchain is kept up, maintained, and created in the first place. So perhaps a simpler way to look at it is as following. Basically, a transaction is requested. So you want to send one Bitcoin from one address to another address. Then this data, this transaction goes into a block together with all different transactions. And this block is sent to every node in the entire Bitcoin network, and then they validate the transaction and receive a reward for proof of work. These are the miners, and then the block is added and the transaction has gone through. All right, so with that, we have reached the end of this video. Again, if you want to know more about the content, if you want to check out the articles, the links will be down in the description. But for now, if you found this video helpful, please make sure to add a like and add comments with questions I might have missed, and subscribe to our channel.